Good morning, my soccer universe. Let's get a few Premier League games yesterday with interesting results. Didn't see any highlights, but I just wanted to go through those. We had, I think, Huddersfield Wolves was the big surprise. 1-0 for Huddersfield, so last place team wins. Another one that was a little bit surprising to me, but I was happy about, Newcastle winning against Burnley 2-0. We had also Everton winning at Cardiff City. This thingy is falling and falling and falling, and I don't want to have it fall. Everton winning at Cardiff City 3-0, getting ready for the Merseyside derby this weekend. This weekend, a crazy slate of games. We'll talk about that in a sec. And then the last result is Leicester winning against Brighton 2-1. Of course, they have a new coach in Brendan Rodgers. I'm not sure. I mean, Leicester under Claude Puel was a team that could get points off the big boys, but also always had trouble against the smaller teams. And that, I think, is where I think the problem lies in their play. Now, with Brendan Rodgers, they have sort of a big name-ish coach where, honestly, I have to say that he is giving up Celtic for Leicester tells you everything about the status of the Premier League, because to me, Celtic is a bigger team than Leicester. Just, but maybe not anymore. The Premier League clearly is the premier competition, and you probably can get more achieved, or you can do better for yourself if you are successful in the Premier League than if you're in the SPL. I still, it a little bit boggles my mind, but you know. I always say, that's the one thing I dislike, that the big four leagues, even medium teams, are head and shoulders above really big teams with tradition. And I'm thinking mainly about Ajax, but also the Glasgow teams fit right in there. Okay, what did I watch? Well, can you guess? Coppa Italia semi-final. Before we got to that one, there was also a Coupe de France. I think it was quarterfinal, could be semi-final, I don't even know, but PSG won against Dijon 3-0, that's what I know. But yeah, we had Coppa Italia, Lazio against Milan. Also, I cannot tell you much about there, except that I think for a fraction of a second it seemed like Milan might get the better, and then in the last 20-25 minutes Lazio, of the first half, Lazio probably should have scored, they were the better team. I was pleasantly surprised that both teams played in the first kit. That's always a nice surprise. And thanks to Lazio's wonderful home kit, this was possible, that Milan can also wear white shorts with the red, and black. But Milan looked defensively super sound and offensively poor. I especially didn't like Paquetá this time around. He looks a bit overplayed in a way. I think it's, you know, I really like Paquetá, but I didn't like him yesterday. He didn't look very convincing, and then Cassie had to come off with a probably hamstring injury. That didn't help Milan, and so it's Piontek hanging in the air on the front. And frankly, he's not the player who will build up the game. No, he's the focal point. So going forward, Milan was not good, and Lazio should have taken the lead. I mean, I think Milinkovic-Savic and Patrick really gave them lots of trouble. Curiously enough, Immobile was a non-factor. That I thought was interesting. Well, second half was a little bit more even, but still I would say slight advantage Lazio. I think towards the end I thought Milan could get something going, but every offensive effort ended in losing the ball relatively quick, and yeah, that didn't look good. This was the first Milan game in a long time where I thought that didn't look good. but you know, it ends up in a 0-0 draw. Immobile had a clear chance on goal that went then off the post, but it was anyway waved offside, and it would have been an offside, so I think this would have been waved off pretty clearly. And then I think the only real thing of note was a tackle of Patrick, where there should have been a red card. I mean, this was really a reckless tackle that would have deserved a red card. But other than that, what can I say? 0-0. I think for Milan this is a good result. What of course is a bad thing is that now we had the first set of games, and the second, the return leg, is somewhere in April. It tells you about the competition, that they cannot get this a little bit closer together. I don't like that. But I said, many games today we have, actually, there are three mildly, I mean, there's one very interesting game, this is the Clásico. And probably that's everyone, what everyone will be watching. But we also have Chelsea, Tottenham. We have Liverpool at home to Watford, which could be a tricky game in the Premier League. And we have Coppa Italia, Atalanta at Fiorentina, which, yeah, doesn't sound as nice as Milan Lazio, but I think those two teams are more offensively minded, so there could be something happening. But I think it's pretty clear that you gotta watch the Clásico, because that's the one Clásico that will count. Of course, we have another Clásico this weekend, and if you look at the schedule of games we have this weekend, it's incredible. We have not only the Clásico, we have the Merseyside Derby, which is a pretty decent matchup. We have in Italy the Rome Derby, and we have in Italy Juve Napoli. I hope it works out that I can watch all of it. I'm just afraid that scheduling will prevent that. But that is a pretty darn nice slate of games, I have to say. And yeah, a little bit, some of those are a bit nerve-wracking, but I actually don't know who Milan will play now. I want to say Sassuolo, but I'm not 100% on that. I think they're playing Sassuolo. So the Rome derby comes at the right time. I mean, again, I want the Roma to win, but a draw might be good for Milan. So we'll see how things are working out. A very interesting week, and we don't even have Champions League. And yeah, scheduling worked out well. Anyway, let me know which games you were, which games you watched yesterday, if you saw the Milan game, would you agree with my assessment? I'm very much from the Milan perspective. Yes, I'm a Milan fan, so that's where I'm coming from. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of these, and I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, here are some videos and playlists that might be of interest to you too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel, as it will give you all the updates on my channel, all things My Soccer Universe. And with that, I want to wish you a wonderful day.